After watching this video, you might want to check your transmission immediately on your Suzuki Bugman. So, at just 4,000 km, I noticed a very unusual vibration coming from the engine when I'm driving at slow speed. So I decided to get it checked by the dealer technician. They diagnosed that the vibration might come from the transmission, so we decided to clean the transmission on the Suzuki Bugman. So we started by removing the transmission cover, which is held in by 5 bones. To remove the middle bone, simply press down the kickstart. You can use the normal wrench, and we use the impact gun for faster disassembly. After that, we can remove all the bones by hand. We can use the ratchet to access the two tight bones which the impact gun cannot reach. Also, we remove the two bones connecting the cover with the air filter box. Then, just use some force to yank the transmission cover out. And we really did not expect the transmission assembly this dirty. I mean, the detail is all covered in dust, and which it might cause by friction during the operation. So we disconnect the pressure hose out of the transmission cover to completely remove the cover out of the scooter. Take a quick look at the transmission cover to see how dirty it is. I wish try. We discovered that without the transmission cover, the engine would not start. The cover also have the middle gear attached to it, and so without that gear, the starter cannot rotate the flywheel. Therefore, the engine will not start. Anyway, to clean the assembly, we simply untie the flywheel bolts, and then the bolt which is held the ribbon bullet, and then we can remove the ribbon bullet by hand. Oh man. You can see that how much of the dust from the clutch inside the bullet. The material is wear out way too fast for a 4,000 km scooter. So we remove the clutch shoes and other components for better cleaning. For the transmission belt, do not use any chemical to clean it, as it may harm the rubber, so making it brittle and reduce the lifespan. Instead, we just need the pressurized air to clean the surface. Then we can remove the rest of the component out of the transmission. So we use the special chemical to clean all the dust, the grease, the oil that stick on the housings. And notice that the chemical quickly turned black. This means that the transmission is so dirty, even though it is just a low mileage scooter, which is relatively new. I just bought it like 5 or 6 months ago. We can clearly see the before and after when we clean the transmission housing. The metal look right inside as new. And now for the bad part. This ribbon bullet have been worn out quite fast, and the burn mark indicated that there have been a lot of heat affected on this bullet when we driving too hard. And I also want to remind you that this is just a 4,000 km scooter, so I think that the design, the engineer may decided to use the bad material might let the component to wear out relatively quickly. At least the transmission clutch shoes don't look too bad. It just need a little bit of cleaning. So after applying chemical cleaner, the metal cover is shined as new again. Look at the dirty chemicals in the bowl below. We carefully clean and assemble all the components of the drive bullet. Notice some slight wear on the roller, and only one or two roller have a black mark on them. So I might need to change it sooner or later. But for now, let's just focus on cleaning this transmission. We show you how it's done, and so you might do it yourself at home when needed. The process is quite easy to follow. Just be careful not to rub any component as they are sensitive. Then install the right bullet to the engine shaft. Install the middle gear for the starter motor. and apply some grease to the shaft to prevent the friction. We place the rubber belt on the transmission to install the flywheel. This is the cooling fin, which is used for effectively cooling inside the transmission. We just need to screw it, the bolt to hold it in place. Next, we carefully slide in the belt to the driven pulley assembly. The reset is easy, just the reverse when we remove the whole assembly before. Just make sure don't damage the belt by twisting it too hard. We install the bolt to hold the driven pulley in place first. Then we use the impact gun to evenly tie the two bolts. For the rear bolt, just press the rear brake to prevent the wheel spinning. Therefore, making it easier to tie the bolt. Finally, we reinstall the transmission cover to the engine and make sure to connect the air hose to the cover first. We already checked for any debris that might clog the pipe, and this is good. Carefully reinstall the cover to the engine, the housing, and the cover design. Don't need the gasket in between. I don't know what is your opinion on this design, but I would prefer the own gasket design to prevent the leaks. Then install the bolt on the transmission cover. Finally, tie all the bolt in the transmission cover. Now, this bike is low mileage and I'm not a racer by any means. The amount of debris and dirt is quite concerning. As other scooter, they don't get that bad in the same condition as the Bugman. So we test drove it for another month. We put on the bike about 700 km to check for the transmission condition. And the whole scooter feel very smooth to ride and no vibration whatsoever. So the bike feels like new. After watching this video, you may want to get your Bugman checked. The Suzuki Bugman might need to clean the transmission more often to ensure the driving experience, which is quite a bad side of this scooter. Anyway, thanks for watching, and if you find this video helpful, leave like and subscribe.